So Lakshman sir and Rohan, I am absolutely thrilled that we could have you both today together to talk about arguably Hindi cinema's best film this year, which is Mimi, streaming now on Netflix. I mean, it's such a wonderful film. So before we go ahead, I just wanted to congratulate you both on this wonderful film that you've created. So congratulations.
Thank you so
Thank you,
much.
Anuj. Thank you very much.
Fabulous. So just beginning from the beginning itself, actually, I mean, I think Lakshman sir and Rohan, I think your frequent collaborations began with Lal Bokchi Rani in 2016, which is a story about a mentally challenged woman who basically is roaming around in Mumbai, and she basically changes and touches the lives of many people. And it sort of centers around the theme of innocence versus experience as well. So how obvious, I guess, was that film choice for you to come together again for Mimi?
I'll tell you actually. So I wanted to be a writer. I was roaming around for a writing job, and I was doing assistant director and so many odd jobs. And I did a production job once for a writer called Shantanu Srivastava, who wrote co-wrote Badhai Ho, and so he has written Tevar. Lakshman sir was shooting the film Tevar, and he asked me, "Do you want to work with Mr. Lakshman Uddegar?" I said, "I heard so much about him, you know, because he shot Blue and Boss and all those big movies." Well, obviously, and I have seen. I think I there was a discussion on his first directorial film Tapal. I remember that it went to some film festival, won awards and all that. So I met Lakshman sir, and he told me this interesting idea about a girl who get lost in the city, and so immediately I think we discussed, and Lakshman sir ne immediately give me a check. I said, "You start writing," and I started writing that film. So it took like 6, 7, 8 months, but yeah, since then we are collaborating. Lal Bagh Rani, then we did Luka Chuppi and Mimi. But yeah, so my first writing break is Lakshman sir launched me as a writer.
Talented. I have given the one of the most talented writer to the industry.
So I'm being blessed that you write. Yeah.
Yeah, that is very true, actually. And I think, you know, since you have mentioned Luka Chuppi as well, and we're talking about Mimi as well, I mean, the Indian states seem to form a very pivotal backdrop to all your films. I mean, I believe Luka Chuppi was based in Mathura and then Gwalior, and then Mimi it is set in Rajasthan, and both of them tackle taboo subjects as well. So, what in particular determines you to base the stories in these particular geographical locations, and how essential is it to start the conversations that you have in those two films at those locations and at those cities as well, in particular? Lakshmana sir, would you like to answer this?
I think in our country, we have so many cultures, so many language, so many colors. So, and especially in small town, like whether it is Mathura, whether it is Chanderi, whether it is Gwalior, Indore, Mandawa. So every small town has their own color and own flavor. And when you add those flavors to the film, it becomes colorful. It becomes for us, it becomes for Indians, it becomes like a festival. You know, like you have everything what you have seen, what you know about that town. Yes, for us, for me and Rohan, because we both come from Maharashtra, so we are both a Marathi. So for us, like when we were writing Luka Chuppi and when we were pitching the film, many people were saying, yeah, how you both are Marathi, how you guys are going to pull off this subject. But we used to tell them that when James Cameron wrote Avatar,
Yeah, we had this so many examples. Like, what if a Hollywood writer sits there and write a film about Syria and India? You know what? They know what nobody doubts them,
it's
but you
true.
doubt if a Maharashtrian is making movie on UP or a Bihari is making movie on Maharashtra. You know, so that it all.
So I must tell you for that, when we were pitching, actually nobody was believing that we will pull off. So
Wow.
Rohan changed his name.
Oh wait, what? Really?
No, so the my thing is, see, my surname is Ghugge. I'm a Maharashtrian. I've always wanted to put my father's name. So when I initially thought it was Rohan Shankar Ghugge, you know, but then it sounds huge, like, no, so I don't want it to compete with Sanjay Leela Bhansali. So, so I said Rohan Shankar sounded so nice. I kept that Rohan Shankar. And then what happened is suddenly there was like no questions. See, okay. And suddenly I felt
Many many
you're
people
getting.
thought Rohan Shankar means he's South Indian.
Oh, he must be from Mathura. So most of the people don't know, but okay, you're writing a UP film or you're. So I think that sometimes we just judge people on their surnames and, you know, where they're from and if they can pull off this kind of film or everything. I remember when I narrated the draft to Lakshman sir, Luka Chuppi, so he said, yeah, this is your also Maharashtra, I'm Maharashtrian, you're writing a script on Mathura. Have you been there? I said, no. So he said, let's go first. So we went to Mathura, we went to Vrindavan, Gwalior, we stayed there, we wrote another draft. We incorporate the cultures, incorporated, and we, even in the location of the actual location were written in the script. So when we came back, we knew everything about those places.
Right.
The
But
same thing we did.
that's our practice for even for Mimi. What we do
Yeah.
when Rohan is done with the first draft, we go to find the town, as
Right.
you said. So, and there are so many beautiful towns in our country, so many beautiful places in our country. So for what we do, our first round is to just hunt at the town which will suit the story. Once we get that town, we both stay there for 10 days, 15 days. We just roam around, we just sit on the ghat, we talk to random people, we make friends over there. And then for us as a maker, as a director, or as a writer, it is very easy to incorporate the available colors and available flavor in the film.
Indeed.
Then what happens to your character? They doesn't look out of the world. They look, they are from the same world, and that's how audience can believe them that, oh, they are from Mandawa. Okay.
Yeah, I mean the location is then a part of location is a character.
It's a
Location is a story.
character.
So I remember that even Mimi, we were seeing some different towns initially. We even went to MP and some other places. We went, stayed there, and we said, oh no, this is not probably working. Then one day Lakshman sir called me, he was shooting some ad film or something in Delhi. He said, I found a town. So you come. So he went to Rajasthan, he already saw the town. I went there. You know, it was beautiful. Manda was beautiful, and we stayed there. There are so many havelis and everything. And then we came up with the character of Manoj Pawa, sir, who's a singer, because Mandawa is a culturally rich town, and there's so many artists initially. There was like, you know, from British era, this Rajasthani sing folk singer, the culture of tradition of folk singing is big. So we incorporate those minor things, detailing in the characters when we finalize Mandava. So yeah, always help. It's a great practice, I guess.
Yeah, and you know, there's a statement that you both made actually, where if you are a certain culture and you're trying to make a film about another culture, there's often this sense of skepticism. And you know, people are often unsure as to, you know, why you're doing that. So why do you think that is that exists? And was it that case as well for you and Mimi as well?
And not for Mimi, because I think not for Mimi, because we already have made a film on UP and in heartland of India and small town of UP. Luka Chuppi worked very well. People loved it. Even people from Mathura and all, they got related. They used to, could relate to the characters and the story. So after Luka Chuppi, we didn't find any trouble or difficulty that they can pull off Rajasthan or something. But yes, this exists. This exists everywhere because generally we are like that, you know, we think of if you're from different background, can you speak this language? We always feel Maharashtrian can speak good Hindi. Then we always think that, you know, Northeast people, Northeastern brothers, they probably can't speak good Hindi, but they can. And we know so many friends. So this is a general perception that sometimes happen, but yes. I think we from Luka Chupi worked, so now there are no questions. I mean, we can go to any part of the world.
We have proven.
Yeah, definitely. It's true. Cinema, as they say, is a universal language. And I think that quote is very apt in any sort of interpretation we choose to integrate it in as well. And I think surrogacy, for some reason, I still feel is quite a taboo topic. But I think what Mimi has done, it has started a lot of conversations about it, especially regarding the legal and ethical aspects of it. But I think coming to you both, how informed were you both about the subject of surrogacy? And having done the film, in what way has it changed your opinion on the way surrogacy is handled in India?
Yeah, I think we initially knew the basic things about surrogacy. We knew that how IVF is done and how this procedure is, because we have heard, we saw a movie, we read, and we know some people who have done it, and there's some people in film industry who has done it. But we, when the subject came and we started researching about it, we got to know that it was a very, it was a in earlier 2000, early 2000, before 2013, 2015, the new surrogacy bill came. Before that, India was like a hub for surrogacy for foreigners. So they used to come and they were like, if you see Mimi, the first scene of the film is about a surrogacy clinic, where in a small room you see 10, 15 women are pregnant surrogate and they are staying, you know, in a very different atmosphere. So that was a very dark side of surrogacy that we got to know when we started researching and everything. And but later we realized how sensitive this subject is. So we tried to stick to emotions, and even met so many gynecologists. I met the gynecologic and IVF doctor in Jaipur also. We shot in a clinic, which is actually a surrogacy clinic in Jaipur, where we shot the film. So there are so many aspects that we got to know, and especially the human stories, because there were so many foreigner couples who came and who aborted the child. There were so many stories like that. There was a story of a Japanese couple, the stories of another American couple. So yes, it was a die. Nobody really touched those sides and subject. But when this concept of story came to us, we tried to explore it in our own way.
This was a Marathi film called Malai Vahitsa.
Yeah, I was going to come to that actually. Yeah.
It was in 2011, 2012, I guess. So we had, Madoc Films, Dinesh Vijayan had rights of Malai Vahitsa. Malai Vahitsa, it was emotionally very heavy film. So what we did, we just took the heart of the film, the soul of that film, and we created our own world. We created our own characters. We add more colors to it. We knew what is surrogacy is about. But what Rohan did was, see, for us, it's very easy to understand what is surrogacy. But for the rickshaw driver or taxi driver, you know, for him to understand what is surrogacy, what Rohan has done is, in a very simple language, he has translated what is surrogacy is.
Right.
It's like, there is a dialogue in the film, ke pet aapka, bachcha inka, you know. Yeah, fir there is another dialogue in the film, ke, unki zameen kharab hai, to aapki zameen aur khad aur beech kisi aur ka.
Bilkul.
So what Rohan has done is, in a very simple language, entire India could understand, entire world could understand what is exactly surrogacy is. And the film is not only about surrogacy. The film is also about two mothers. Film is also about the relationship, the pure bonding between Mimi and Bhanu, you know. The film is about, basically our idea was to make a film on surrogacy and have entire family to watch the film.
Yeah.
Make it an entertainer package, basically. So without hurting what is actually surrogacy, without hurting anyone's emotions, without hurting, you know, any sides of surrogacy, idea was to entertain people make them laugh, make them cry, again make them laugh, and again make them cry.
Yeah, because tell a story. Surrogacy was a, it's a subject, it's a medium, like living in Luka Chupi, like surrogacy in Mimi. But there was a story, there's this emotional story and characters and journey of Mimi, journey of the characters, like 5-6 years of journey in 2 hours that we tried to tell. So this was that.
Yes, and I'm really glad you mentioned this, because that's what I felt as well. In the film, I thought there was this very beautiful marriage of education and entertainment. You know, I feel like it kind of very interlinked beautifully, because I have seen a lot of films which are very preachy, and they've matlab bina kuch just unsolicited, they just added facts in and just made political statements and statements just for the sake of sounding woke when it doesn't actually fit with the storyline at all. But the beauty about Mimi is that it's so beautifully weaved in. I think for you both as a director and as a writer as well, how do you strike that perfect balance within a film and make sure that it's, you know, engaging and entertaining to watch, as well as perhaps insightful and, you know, thought-provoking to an extent as well?
We have done it in the first film that we have done, Lal Bagh Chirani. So the film is not available. So many people wanted to see. I also want to see again.
Yeah, I want to see.
In that, that is the first film, and we did something like this in the first film, where there was humor, there was a sensitive subject, there were emotions, and there were characters, and there was a story who's flowing. So kind of we were experienced, and we can say, in this.
I think we learned after Luka Chupi.
Oh, yeah, really? And we learned so many things after Luka Chupi. Yeah.
Because I'll tell you, Anuj. After when Luka Chupi released, and when we went for a theater visit, and when we saw 250 people laughing together, you know, and that's when we thought that's fun, you know, to make people laugh. It's
fun,
you know, it's a challenge. And this time we decided, let's make them cry as well.
Right.
So because the film had those kind of emotions, you know. And so we got opportunity to make people laugh, make people cry. And more than that, I would say, in this kind of situation where the entire world is going to disturb state of mind. You know? And in this kind of situation, what makes us feel happy and satisfied is everywhere, like we are getting calls that people are watching Mimi with their family.
Yeah.
You know, because otherwise, if you have 2 BHK, 3 BHK, you know, somebody is watching something on their iPad, someone is watching something on their laptop, someone is watching something on their phone. But Mimi is the only film, it's a pure family film, which everywhere people are watching with their mother, father, sister, daughter, with the family. And I think that's what makes us more happy and satisfied.
Correct. Yeah.
That's wonderful. Now, and I think also, I mean, you know, it has released on Netflix, and like you said, everyone is consuming it everywhere, different parts of the world. I mean, even a cousin of mine who is a single mother, and she only watches Bollywood very, very occasionally, but she loved Mimi, and she related so much to the whole soul of the film as well. So it's quite wonderful to see that response. But do you kind of wish that it released in cinemas? Do you think that, I mean, obviously not that it's ever a testament to how successful a film is, but obviously I do feel a film like Mimi would have definitely reached the 100 crore mark, I think, had it released in cinemas too. So do you both kind of wish ki kaash for cinema release hoti, kaash communal viewing hota? Do you kind of wish that happened as well?
Of course we wish that. I mean, releasing film in the theater, it's kind of festival for filmmakers.
Yeah.
It's kind of event for filmmakers when your film, 150 or 250 people watching together. And when you see the big poster of your film outside the theater, it is the kind of festival for any filmmaker. But we are still satisfied because the kind of love we are getting for Mimi on OTT. You know, I don't think I have seen this kind of love and this kind of praise for any Hindi film in last
couple. Yeah, the reception is quite good because it reached to a wider audiences in 2-3 days, in no time. Through OTT, it reached to like huge audience. That was the best part of this OTT release, and the family saw it. People are like going on Twitter and they're trending some dialogues, and I'm receiving so many messages. Sir is receiving. I mean, Kriti, Pankaj, everybody is receiving so many messages that they love the film. I think that's the power of OTT also, that it reaches to a lot of people. But yes, cinema halls do have magic. I mean, to see your film, hear those music and sound and emotion in a big screen, that's definitely a different experience.
Yes, for sure. I think coming back to Lakshman, sir, what you said about the, social issues that Mimi touches on. I mean, besides surrogacy, it has a lot of layers, including topics regarding gender and class and color disparity in India, as well as subtle hints towards certain types of divorces as well that used to be active as well. So when helming or writing such a film, do you as a director or writer ever feel a sense of social and moral responsibility as well?
Well, yes. See, we are so lucky that we are in this medium. And it is our individual responsibility towards the society, because cinema has a huge impact. And we are not here just for the stand-up comedy. You know, we want to make people laugh, we want to make people cry, but same time we want to give them something to think. You know, like if you see Mimi, the first frame of the Mimi is we see many surrogate women.
Yes.
They are in pain. But the moment that doctor comes out, we show that four, five kids, beggar kids, they're fighting for the chips. The women inside, they're carrying kids in their belly for somebody else. But at the same place, there are kids, nobody's ready to carry them.
So true. Yeah.
And that circle we have completed in the end.
That's a subtle hint actually for the climax.
Yeah, it's foreshadowing.
Wonderful.
So yes, I think as a filmmaker, it is our responsibility to don't just make them laugh, or don't just, we have to give them something to think, because cinema has a huge impact on everyone.
We have also grown up watching. I mean, we have grown up watching. You know, Joe, the cinema of, if you really see what used to happen, and even whether it is Bimal Roy film, Hrishikesh Mukherjee film, all those films, all the great films, they had stories, they had songs, they always had some social issue. Even a film like Sholay, they had some characters and issue, and they really talked smoothly in the screenplay about something. This is what Indian cinema has always been. That we find character or some time, and whatever progressive thing, if we can say, in smoothly in the context of the story, then it's a good feeling. It's an achievement, I think, we see. It's a good achievement.
Yes, indeed. But I also think, though, there has been a huge influx of Indian films which revolve around societal issues and subjects and presented through the comedic route. I mean, the first few films that I can think of immediately are Is Badhai Ho and Good News, for example, or any other Ayushman Khurrana film, basically, so do you kind of feel that social comedies, in a way, I mean, I know, Rohan, you just talked about it, but do you feel that social comedies now have become almost like a new genre in Bollywood? And why do you think that such stories are gaining prominence? I mean, is it actually because of the novelty of the concept? Or is it because that, they've seen one film doing well, so everyone's trying to jump on that bandwagon now and trying to create more such stories?
See, it's not like we are making this cinema now. We have been making in 60s and 70s also. We were touching every subject. Our characters, protagonists were farmers. They were soldiers. They were like common people. And in somewhere in some few years, we lost it and we went to a different cinema. Even still in 80s parallel cinema, there was cinema, was touching everything. Yes, in social comedy, I guess what happened is, like Lakshman sir came, I came, we brought our stories, our experiences from the lower middle class background, what we have seen. He has seen, and you can actually make a film on Lakshmi Muttika's life, because if you, wow. It's the way the, he came and how he struggled and how he achieved all those things. It's a great, so he has seen so many things. He has seen, so when he's making a movie, he will definitely say something. And he will definitely want to make a movie on a substance, the story that has substance. Same for me. The same for people. So I think what cinema has changed, because the people were coming, like Pankajji once said a good thing, that because Pankaj Tripathi came from Bihar, or Lakshmi Uttekar came from a village of Maharashtra, or you came, or there's so many people came and they brought their own stories and they want to make make it commercial also. They want through stories to reach to wider people also. So they are treating it a light, funny way. So I think that has changed. Like new filmmakers and writers and everything, actors, they are coming. And they want to tell stories, want to entertain, but still with some substance, with some thing, if they can, you know, say. I think that's the reason we have so many. And I think it will grow from now on, which is a great thing.
Mm-hmm. Lakshman sir, would you like to add to this? I'd love to get your perspective actually as a filmmaker too, because as Rohan said, you know, you've witnessed your deal of hardship in life and, you know, dealing with this sort of class disparity that we often see in your films. So I guess for you to channel that that pain and grief and that hardship through a comedic route, how challenging is that for you as a filmmaker as well?
I think it's not at all challenging. I mean, it's what we have lived, as Rohan said. And you can see the difference in current days cinema. Like many filmmakers, writers and directors, they're coming from small town. So they're coming with their own experience. They're coming with their own stories which they have experienced. And that's why it's very easy for them to translate those stories, you know, on screen. And for me, actually, personally, throughout my journey, whatever I did, I was enjoying. So it was fun for me. I mean, people said, oh, he did these things. Oh, he washed car. Oh, he sold vada pav. But for me, it was fun. I was enjoying those moments in my life. So right. I took the pain in a funny way. So I think even in the kind of work me and Rohan we do, we try to not make it painful.
Okay.
You know, not make it sad. It could be emotional, but not at all sad. So I
remember, sorry, one thing that when I started writing Lal Bagh Chi Rani, the story about this girl, mental challenge girl who lost in city. And I just asked Lakshman, sir, so how you want to show Mumbai? I remember that day, because anything can happen with the girl, right? She's mental challenge and she's roaming around the street, she's alone, she's lost. And Lakshman sir said, I've lived in this city for so many years, I've struggled so many years, there were so many things, good things, bad things happened with me, but I always saw this city in a very positive way. So I just want to see Mumbai in a very positive way, that, you know, this is a city that helps, this is a city that takes you somewhere, this is a beautiful city. So that is this approach towards everything. So that's what that stayed with me.
I think we both have a very positive perspective towards, you know, every script.
I mean, we create situation where character stuck, but we also want to create another situation where they come out, feel happy and good ending, and people should take something. Yeah, that's it.
For sure. And I think also, I really want to here give a special mention to the music of Mimi. I mean, when I heard that A.R. Rahman had come on board to the music, I was very pleasantly surprised, because I was not expecting it at all. I mean, after the really peppy and cool soundtrack that we had for Luka Chupi, I mean, to hear a very soul-stirring soundtrack for Mimi, it was so wonderful. And I think what's really special again about the Mimi soundtrack is that it's not only melodious, but it's also highlighting different aspects of motherhood. You know, we have the different aspects. You have the, you know, the celebration aspect. You have the carefree aspect of Mimi before she decides to become a mother, and then the sentimental aspect when she actually becomes a mom as well. So Lakshman sir, I guess how conscious was your decision of choosing Rehman sir for the soundtrack, and what was the brief you gave him as well?
Actually, to be very frank, Anuj, we both should say thanks to Dinesh Vijayan for this.
Yes. Oh, yes. Absolutely. Maddox Films, for yeah. sure. 100%.
Because,
yeah.
You know, nowadays, it is very difficult to have producers who can invest. Like Mimi doesn't have action. Mimi has no romance.
Yeah, I was going to say, actually, I'll mention that as well later.
Besides that, having such a great support from the producer, mm-hmm. you know, and banking for the project and investing only on the content, that this will work. Actually, we met Rehman sir after our first schedule of Mimi. So we did two schedules. So we did first 20 day schedule, then we took 2 months break for Kriti to gain weight. So we wanted her to gain weight by 15 kg. And then we did another schedule, which was 20 days. So after first schedule, we edited first half and we showed it to Rehman sir.
Wow.
And he just loved it. And he said, I haven't done this kind of cinema for longest time, and I would love to do it. And emotionally, he was connected with the film. And that's how, like, if you see those, all the songs and music of Mimi, mm-hmm. they are just for the film.
Yeah.
You know?
Compliments.
They are not individual. Yeah. I mean, sometimes you may feel, when you just hear the song, you may not like it that much.
Mm.
But when you see the same song with the emotions,
yeah,
you know, Rahman sir's music and the songs, they take emotions on the, you know,
next level, and the music grows on you. It's, I mean, so that one, twice, thrice, and it grows on you so much, you know, that after a time you are just listening to those songs.
Right.
So that's the magic of, I think, Rahman sir's music.
Yes, and even a dance lover like Param Sundari. I mean, I think everyone, I've listened to this so many times, and I think this is going to be literally probably one of my anthems of this year. We've had Pangat and we've had Pani Pani. I think this one definitely joins that anthem of the year sort of collection. But it's just so wonderfully how it really beautifully, you know, sort of showcased Mimi's character as well. And, you know, I think that's the beauty. And like you said, it just completely elevates the emotions to another level. And I also love, Lakshman sir, like how you mentioned, you know, the fact that even though Pankaj Tripathi and Kriti Sanon are the lead characters or lead actors in the film, so to speak, I mean, so is Sai as well, but I guess these two in particular, because they are in the film together, they're not love interests. And I think that was such a refreshing move, the fact that you've had a film with a boy and a man and a woman, and they're not love interests at all. And I think that was so refreshing as well. And I guess Rohan, you must be very conscious as well, right, to make sure that it doesn't delve into a typical love story or a typical sort of romance, you know.
No, actually, when we started, we were clear. Me and Lakshman, we were clear. When the character of Bhanu came, his film starts with Bhanu. Mm-hmm. Actually, then he takes these people to Mimi. So we were always clear that, you know, then we already thought of that Bhanu will be having a family. Initially, we had a scene where there was a family of Bhanu in the first scene. Then Bhanu comes and then he drives and everything in the screenplay. So we always clear that Bhanu and Mimi are not going to be together. But definitely, then a point came when Mimi says, okay, he's the father. You know, that's the interesting screenplay. Situation comes in the screenplay, which changes everything. And we knew that. We are clear that it's not going to happen.
In fact, when we cracked the story and when we started, before we started writing, we both had imagined that Bhanu is Pankaj Tripathi and
yeah.
Mimi is Kriti Sanon. Before even telling them, before even telling Dinesh Vijayan, we in our mindset we had decided that these two are playing the these characters, and as per keeping them in the mind, Rohan started writing the dialogues.
Oh, yeah.
And so we stayed with the character, but we narrated to Pankaj later, and he liked it. But you know, when I used to write a line, and then I realized, oh, so Pankaj is going to say this. It will be damn fun if you're going to say this. And then Kriti, and there were so many big lines. Actually, the thing with Mimi is the thing with is the ki there were so many big emotional lines, 7, 8, 9 lines. You know, a paragraph is a paragraph, like half page of lines, emotional lines of Mimi and Bhanu and even Summer, the Evelyn who played, and all so many characters. So I think, but the fun was the way actors said all those lines, when Lakshmi sir, the way he executed it, the way it's edited, it came out so well. Then it is problem for me, because next time whenever I'll write something, you know, it needs to have all those things. If your lines are good, okay, but you need to have all those things. You need to have these actors. You need to execute it the way, edit it the way that come out. So yeah, we were, you know, there was, we were not, you definitely knew that there, the fun was not, unique thing was this, na, that Pankaj ji is not going to be with Kriti and there was no track. If, what if, agar matlab wo hota, to fir kuch fun nahi hota. I mean, like, it's only expected thing and obvious thing.
It would have, honestly, it would have really done a disservice to the originality of Mimi. You know,
honestly,
love story, because hum sab matlab yahi sochte ki jitna bhi marzi kar lo, jitna bhi quoting kar lo, ghuma phira ke matlab bas love story hi aani hai. So I think the good thing is definitely that, you know, we had this sort of very different angle and dynamic sort of angle.
Even Kriti हमेशा पूछती थी यार इसके लाइफ में कोई लड़का नहीं है क्या?
Oh wow, really?
Kriti used to ask like always, yeah, एक तो लड़का होगा, कोई तो होगा. You know, था पहले कहानी से, you know.
हाँ, and I'm glad, and that लड़का actually ended up being Raj, her little baby. That was the main character, which she also mentions as well in the film. Actually, I remember when they're walking together. But I think Lakshman sir, and I think Rohan as well here. You know, in both your films, Lukka Chuppi and Mimi, the lead female characters, which both are played by Kriti Sanon, you know, they sort of transition from being these ambitious youngsters to becoming mature and protective adults, you know, to kind of, you know, Sayana. I think Sayana is the word that I can use here as well, that they become Sayana. I mean, so what helps you, I guess, to present this life journey so smoothly in your work, and that too from a female's perspective as well?
Even for Lukka Chuppi, the Kriti's character was the, you know, catalyst or kind of a thing. She demands this and then the story happens. It was then Mimi also is Mimi's story. I think it was a plot that we had in mind both the times, and women at the center of the plot, and, you know, taking decision, and the plot revolves around her and taking her to somewhere. So yeah, it's not all male or female. I feel it's the plot and the strong character, and women characters are like the first film we did was women centric was completely this girl. And then Lukka Chuppi, we are a stronger character. Mimi is completely a female-centric film. So yeah, I think it generally depends on the plot and the character that we have in mind. And we just, when the character flows in the story, on the plot, we also see, okay, she can have this shade, that shade, she can do this, she can do that. We explore the character while writing. In the process, we also explore so many things. It's not that it's completely in our head and we just put it on paper and that's it. We also in the journey explore that Mimi can do this also. Mimi can do that also. She can say these things also, depending on the plot. So that's a fun part of, I think, filmmaking. When the actor comes, she says some lines, then you realize, okay, this also can happen. That's the best part of, that's what I think we, and we don't follow any theories, if I can say it. We enjoy the process, like Akshan sir said. That's a fun.
At the same time, we both try to make our in our film, the female character is strong.
Stronger, yeah.
That's the idea. I mean, we find the way. Like, for example, in Mimi, obviously, it's a film driven by Mimi, right?
Yeah.
But when she's giving birth, her delivery scene. So the idea was to, while shooting that scene, the intention was to, if a boyfriend or husband or son watching that scene with his mother, wife, you know, a girlfriend, while watching that scene, at least once he should look at her. And I mean, he should think that, oh, you go through this kind of pain.
Yeah.
You know, so that respect has to be there.
True.
Because giving birth and jo delivery ka pain hota hai, wo, that pain is so much ke agar kehte hai ki usme se 10% pain agar aadmi ko ho jaye, mard ko ho jaye, to puri duniya ki abadi 50% ho jayegi.
Haan, bilkul. No, very true. Hum andaza bhi nahi laga sakte actually.
Yeah.
So yes, I mean, without hurting the screenplay, we try to gain respect for the women in our film. You know, otherwise, if you see, normally kya dikhate hai, do teen baar cheek liya, bachche ki rone ki awaaz aayi, bachcha ho gaya.
Right.
But if you see it in Mimi, when they bring her to the hospital, it's pitch dark outside. It's like 2:33. And when she's going through a pain, and after giving birth, when doctor comes out to give a good news, it's blue sky outside.
Oh, yes.
So in real life, yes, it's take that much time. Giving birth, it's not a game. It's not easy. We should respect our mother. We should respect our wives. We should respect a female around us. That was the idea. So we both try to find that gap and give that respect to our female characters in our every film.
And to make not just a central character, I mean, in Luka Chupi, we had good, like, Karthik's mother and Bhabhi and Neha and all these actors who played. There was also a strong female characters. It's just not, so because we have been around probably strong mothers and wife and sisters and everything. We have been around, always been around strong women, and that's what we see. I mean, it always is like that. So even Shama.
That too, without making noise, you know.
Yeah.
Like in Luka Chupi, if you see, have you seen Luka Chupi?
Yes, I have.
Vinay Pathak's wife, like Kriti's mother, she's always in the costume.
I remember that, yes.
So that was not written in the script, but when me and Rohan was roaming in the Mathura and Gwalior, we realized that half of our Indian women, they are in pallu. They are not allowed to show their face. So, I mean, you can imagine such a heavy female-oriented society we are in. Male-oriented society we are in. So what we did throughout the film, we kept her in a pallu. And towards the end, we showed her face.
When the character transformed, then he understand, and that's what's a kind of...
The whole crux of the thing. Yeah, I remember Vinay Pathak's character was quite a tyrant in that film. I remember seeing that. He was a very patriarchal, typical patriarchal figure. But I think that's where Mimi gets right, you know. It shows the very progressive attitudes as well, even of the parents of Mimi, beautifully played by Manoj Pawaser and Supriya Pathak, ma'am, who I've been a huge fan of for many, many years now. I mean, even though there was humor in her character as well, there was still that sense of strength of her saying that, no, you know, no matter what's happened, you're still my daughter, and, you know, we're going to see this through, we're going to see this delivery through. And I think that's that conviction that I really enjoyed seeing as well in that film. But I think also, just a bit more on this note as well, especially about Mimi's character. So Kriti Sanon, obviously, I know you both mentioned that you had her in mind when you were writing basically the film. But I guess when Luka Chupi happened as well, so was Kriti Sanon always the first choice for Luka Chupi too, Lakshman Sen Rohan?
Yeah, actually, she was always the first choice. I'll tell you very frankly, because to play Mimi, I wanted someone who has depth and who's comfortable to work with. You know, because this character is such a sensitive character. I wanted to have a rapport with that person. I wanted to have that mindset. And in Luka Chuppi, I had an experience that Kriti, yes, she has so much depth. She's real, first of all. She's not fake.
No, yeah.
You know, she's a real personality. She's a real person. She's not fake at all. And she's hardworking. And if you see her graph in the Mimi, like film starts with the bubbly chubbly Mimi. And within 2 hour, 12 minutes film, if you see the end, she is a mother of 4 years kid, you know? So that those, her performance was like a speed breaker. It's like a roller coaster. And for those kind of sensitive performance, we wanted somebody who's not already established, you know, like who can carry a female-centric film on their shoulder. No, we did not wanted someone like that. We just wanted someone who has depth, who's real, and who's ready to work hard on it. And we both knew that Kriti has that talent and she will kill it. And she has killed it.
She did it, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. On a final note, you know, after tackling the subjects of surrogacy, you know, mental challenges and live-in relationships, which you both have done in your films together, is there a topic you internally exploring next? In fact, Rohan, I'm going to go to you first, actually, because I know you have a film called Helmet coming up, which, again, is a very special film to me because two people that I genuinely admire and love and get on really well with are in the film as well. Pranuthan and I and Apar Shakti are in that film together. So tell me about Helmet as well, and is there any other topic you'd love to explore next in your future films?
So yes, Helmet is, I think Helmet is the Helmet is finalized. They have finalized Sony Pictures, have finalized some deal with some OTT. They will reveal it soon. So soon it will be, we can see the movie. Yes, it's kind of, it's a very, it's also high concept movie, done in a different way, but with good actors. And again, the attempt is to say some things through, you know, humor or something. So I'm really excited about it. It's a very bold, again, topic. And after Mimi, even the entire team of Helmet is feeling very confident because the way Mimi is being received, you know, so that is what happens, you know, a film like this subject, and it received so well by the audiences. Then there's another film is coming. Then there are two more films are coming on bold subject. People want to say something. They get confident. They are happy. Okay, now we are very happy and we'll be confident that the probably will also get good reception like it. Because, and that's what is happening in Hindi film industry, I guess, in the last few years, that some film is working and we are getting confident. Okay. So I remember when we were pitching Luka Chuppi, initially nobody was, you know, because nobody, everybody was in doubt ki how can we yaar ye kaise banayenge, live in town chote shehar mein leke ja rahe, you know, heroism hai nahi, ye nahi hai. But the moment Luka Chuppi got clicked, we met the same people and they wanted another Luka Chuppi. I met so many people who made or was writing films about, because they said, okay, because this worked, now we are confident that's our story also works. So I think for Helmet, we are confident, we are excited. And yes, hopefully it will also come soon. And yes, next topic. So we are discussing topics that we want to do together. Me and Lakshman sir, the problem, the Mimi ke baad thoda expectation bahut bad gaya hai. So we are discussing ab kya kare. The response that we are getting. So I said, let's see what we can explore. But
I have a suggestion, actually, if I may. I really would love to see LGBTQIA relationships explored a lot more. And that too, with that sort of combination of showing that that relationship as well as human emotions, like you beautifully balanced in Mimi. So if you both can somehow, I don't know how, but if you can make a film about homosexual relationships or even, you know, a relationship between any other LGBTQIA member, that would be incredible. So just want to just drop that in there. If you could do that, that would be wonderful.
Keep in mind, definitely.
Yeah,
definitely. You know, the problem is not actually we have thought of it. I said yes, but in reality, in our country, we have to graduate first before making this kind of film. You know, we have to, because if you make a film on homosexual, you will not find a single family who's watching together.
Right. I mean, but I guess Ek Ladki Ko Dekha and Shubh Mangal Zyada Safan changed that a little bit though. Now it's kind of like set that base, I think. You know, so I think...
Yeah, I mean, that's what need to...
on yes, certain level, to, actually.
That's mm-hmm. we need to get a story that can easily woven, tell this topic and easily woven into or presented into a film, family film. Because see, youth, most of the youth knows it, but subject like this, you need to make it reach to the elders and all kind of all every down. Age group. So that's why you need a story like that. You know, so we just keep on thinking of stories we discuss, but yes, definitely we'll keep this thought. We already have some idea, but after Mimi, I think we can definitely think about going into zone and, but thinking a story first that can actually reach to wider people.
Like, sure. And I think Lakshman sir as well, before I let you go, Lukka Chuppi too. I think there's been a lot of anticipation, I think, for that as well. Is that in process at the moment or are you still developing it? What's the status on that?
Actually, we both have no idea who's writing it. We both have no idea. Neither Madoff Films, neither Dinesh Vision. So we have no idea who's writing the script.
Because yes, so actually the thing is, we sat so many times, we thought so many times. For us, the story ended there. So we even discussed few ideas, but couldn't really get through. But I don't know. There was a Wikipedia page on Lukka Chuppi too. So I don't know.
Yeah. Last time I read on the Wikipedia page, apparently it was about a divorced couple. So, you know, I don't know. I think I'm just going to wait and see what happens next and just hopefully just keep my fingers crossed as something jal se jal dikha sujhava.
Yeah, yeah.
But I think on that note, though, Lakshman and Rohan, I mean, it's been an absolute, absolute joy to have you both. I know it's, I think Rohan, you were saying this after a long time, you were saying Lakshman sir as well. And I think it's just so wonderful that...
Yeah, we are together after like years, I think.
Wow. That is incredible. Yeah. That is huge. And I think just having this wonderful discussion about this beautiful, you know, sort of shift that we're seeing in Hindi cinema that, you know, has really strengthened with a film like Mimi is a huge, huge deal. And I think it's a joy for a journalist like me to have this opportunity. So I think a huge congratulations on giving us one of the best films this year in Bollywood, Mimi. And I cannot wait to see this wonderful director-writer combo strengthened with the next film. So thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you, Anuj. Great, lovely chatting, man.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Bye. Take care.
Bye, Rohan.
Bye, sir.